Welcome to the channel of Sir D, where various subjects about the society are discussed, like politics and governance, biblical theology, and criminal justice education, especially in the area of criminology.
Okay, so there you are, no? So our subject is principles of investigation and report writing. As I mentioned a while ago, good command of the English grammar will give you a better, edge on report writing. And of course, technical report writing is skill. Skill ito class. So kailangan to palagi kang sumusulat, lagi mong inuulit, so that mamamaster mo ang iyong grammar or mamamaster mo ang iyong writing. Anything class na sinasabi nating skill, ito ay hindi namamaster sa overnight lamang. Okay, so normally in my subject, technical report writing, I usually ask my student to write using their own handwriting. Okay, I do not want to see, computerized report, because chances are you might just be copy pasted or cut and paste only. Né? Okay, so again, as we go back, ito'y patalastas muna natin. Kapag ang mga estudyante ay hindi nagpakatino, kapag kayo ay HRM, ang bagsak ninyo ay waiter kayo. Kapag midwifery, bagsak nyo later on kung madro na. Kapag education graduate at hindi nagpakatino sa pag-aaral, tambay ang labas nyo. Kayong mga criminology, ang bagsak ninyo tanod o kaya NPA o kaya gangster ang mangyayari sa inyo. Okay? O kaya security guard. Hindi kayo mag-aaral ng 4 years class para maging security guard lang. Okay? Nag-aaral kayo ng 4 years so that kayo ay magiging professional later on. Yung mga kadete sa PMA, kapag di nagpakatino, babagsak niyan, rebuild later on. Sa mga kumukuha ng medisina, pag hindi nagpakatino, albularyo ang labas niyan. Sa mga IT students, pag nagpakatino niyan, sila yung mga tambay sa mga net cafe. Okay? Yung mga accountancy students, ang bagsak niyan, tindera. Ang fine arts, magiging pintor ng pader or pintor ng nitso. Diba? Ang mga psychologists, magiging manghula pag dinagpakatino sa pag-aaral. Ang mga business tourism, ang labas nila ay mga tourist guide or mga driver lamang. Yung mga mascom, magiging bugaw mga yan. Kundi bugaw kasi mascom yan, mas mataas ng konti, doon sila sa call center. Mas mababa, call center sa kalye. Ano alam yung call center sa kalye? Yung sumisigaw ng arayat, tatlo pa, alis na, di ba? Okay. So nursing, magiging katulong or tinatawag nilang caregiver. No? Pinalitan lamang. Noong panahon namin, ang tawag nila ay housewife. Ginawa nilang, housemaid ang sabi. No? Tapos ginawang domestic helper. Ngayon, ginawang caregiver. Pares din trabaho nun. Okay? Sa mga mid-tech, ang labas niyan later on, mga drug pusher. Anyway, let's move on. So, a criminal investigation is only as good as the report that supports it. Okay? So, of course, there is a premise in a police report or in police operation that in every police operation, it should be followed by a police report. So that police operation could either be a simple inspection, a simple patrolling, okay, a simple orientation or a simple inspection of the ranks, okay. Everything that the police, it should always be followed by a police report, okay. And again, the police action or the police operation is clearly remembered or clearly recalled if the report is a good report. Otherwise, yung mga nagbabasa ng report ay tinatawag natin malilito kung ano nga ba talaga ang tunay na nangyari doon. Okay? So again, if we go back to the incident sa ating PDEA QCPD encounter sa Ever Gutesco along Commonwealth Avenue, okay? So somehow yung yung PDEA naglabas kaagad ng after incident report. Even the PNP, naglabas ulit sila ng after incident report. And all the first responders, they also, we call it, submitted their own police report. Okay? All the SOCO officers, they submitted their own report. So everyone who were involved in the incident, whether we call it the actual participants or whether police officers who responded to the crime scene, whatever role they have performed there, more or less they have to support their action with a police report. So a criminal investigation or a police operation or a police action is only as good as the report that supports it. Okay? And so what else? When we investigate or when we operate or whatever police action that we are going to do, normally there are 5 W's and 1 H. If we are speaking of investigation, normally there is what you call the question of who is the investigator or who is an investigator or what is an investigation and what when does an investigation begin. So if we go back to your subject in criminal investigation, an investigator is one who is tasked in finding out the 5 W's and 1 H of a criminal incident. Okay, so again, normally an investigation begins, okay, when the police receives a complaint. No, kapag na-receive nila yung complaint, mag-start yung investigation. At kapag sa investigation or sa pag-start ng investigation, pag tumawag yung complainant or tumawag yung victim sa police, actually nag-i-start na doon ang investigation. So whatever transpires or whatever information na na-receive ni police officer when he receives, okay, when he received the call, ay i-take note na yon kasi part na yon ng investigation. Okay? Part na yon ng kanyang i-report. That a certain caller by the name of, okay, reported that, okay, a shooting incident happened in the vicinity of, okay, or he was a victim of stabbing and the suspect was unknown to him or to her, like that, no? So dun pa lang tinitake note na ng investigator, okay? So hindi nag-start ang investigation doon sa crime scene, but rather once or upon receipt of the complaint or once receipt of the information, investigation already starts at that very point. Therefore, in the report of the police, normally included na yung mga incident prior to his responding to the crime scene or arrival to the crime scene. And normally, in the mindset of a police, okay, we are there must be a probable cause here. Now, we are not going to discuss probable cause here in the context of criminal procedure or in the context of the prosecutor. But rather, we are going to understand probable cause here in layman's term or in the mindset of an ordinary police officer. No, pag sinabing probable cause, mayroong malaking dahilan. Okay? Or mayroong madaling rason or malaking rason. Okay? Or mayroong malaking basihan. Okay, na pag sinabi nating probable cause, that is now the collection of facts or the presence of facts that indicates that a crime is actually or a crime has actually been committed and the suspect is probably guilty thereof. So that is the general context of what is a probable cause insofar as the mindset of a police investigator is concerned. Meaning, kapag naka-receive ka ng report, okay, whether you are a patrol officer or whether you are a DIS officer, okay, pag naka-receive ka ng report, alamin mo kaagad yung 5 W's in 1 H at i-assess mo na or evaluate mo na yung situation, okay, base doon sa tumawag, base sa tono ng boses ng tumawag, okay, base sa appearance ng tumawag, or base sa tinatawag nating other circumstances. So doon, aalamin na ni investigator kung talagang mayroong probable cause na mayroon talagang crime na na-commit. So in the mindset of a police, a probable cause means that a police must have a reasonable belief that a crime has been committed or it is being committed by a suspect or by the suspect. Okay, so that from there pwede na siyang mag-respond sa crime scene. Now, bakit ganun sir ang idea? Kasi ganito yon. Hindi lahat ng tao na nagko-complain ay talagang biktima ng crime. There are people na tinatawag natin hindi naman talaga na biktima ng crime. So, sila lamang ay nagre-report na mayroong crime although wala naman talagang crime na na-commit. For whatever reason, there are some people who will try now to invent stories that they are victimized by a certain criminal incident. And that is now the function of the police to determine the probable cause, to determine the facts, okay, proving that a crime has in fact been committed and the suspect is probably guilty thereof. Okay? So on the other hand, when you say reasonable suspicion, it is an objectively justifiable suspicion. When you say objective justifiable suspicion, it is not dependent on the appearance of the victim. Okay, maaring yung biktima ay punit-punit yung kanyang damit. So sabi mo kaagad, uy, mayroong reasonable suspicion na siya nag-commit ng crime. No, that is not the point when I say objective justifiable suspicion. Pag sabing objective, base ito sa facts. Okay? Base ito sa katotohanan. Hindi lamang sa iyong personal na opinion. Okay? And that is based on specific facts or circumstances that justifies stopping and sometimes searching a person if it involves a stop and freeze search na tinatawag natin. If in case may nag-report, then aalamin mo, suportan mo ng facts. Nag-respond ka sa crime scene, all of a sudden, wala naman palang crime. At the same time, you need to consider also na mayroong mga possibilities ng tinatawag natin mga frank callers ang tawag natin doon. So further, speaking of report writing skills, normally, we use the third person. No? Third person ginagamit natin. Pero sa contemporary writing, they are now, recommending that the first person should be used. When you say first person, in the pronoun I, we, okay, we the patrol officers, okay, I, okay, like that. So that is the first person. However, in matters of expression of respect, no? Sa Pilipino, ang expression natin ng respect ay third person. Pag sinabing third person, kapag kausap mo ay matanda, normally ganito ang sinasabi mo, sino po sila? You do not say, sino po kayo? Because when you say, sino po kayo? Okay, that's a second person. Normally, in the language of the Filipinos, parang kabastusan. That's why when we speak or when we are talking to a person who is not known to us, and normally we say, as a sign of respect, sino po sila? Okay, we refer to them as the third person. Although, siya yung second person kasi siya yung ating kinakausap. Now, yung ating sign of respect na yan ay na-transfer natin sa ating written English or sa ating written reporting na tinatawag natin. Kaya normally, ginagamit natin yung third person. Okay? We use the third person in referring ourselves. Okay? That's why kapag may nangangampanya, sabi nila, ang inyo pong abang lingkod. Ang inyo pong abang lingkod. Hindi niya sinasabi na ako na inyong lingkod. Parang medyo mayroong tinatawag nating kumbaga may pagkamataas yung nagsasalita noon. So kapag narinig nyo yung mga politicians, okay, sabi nila na ang inyong abang lingkod, okay, ang inyong lingkod, ang inyong mayor, no? Hindi na sinasabi na ako na yung mayor, no? So parang authoritative kasi masyado yon. Okay, kaya sa ating traditional na writing sa Filipino, nasanay tayo sa third person. Na sinasabi mo doon, I, the undersigned police officer, or I, the undersigned student, is willing to abide with the rules and regulation of the school. That he further promised that. Okay, so yung instead na sabihin mong I, normally, nire-refer natin yung third person, yung ating sarili. Kasi nga, sa traditional na Filipino language, kapag nire-refer natin yung ating sarili as a third person, or yung ating kausap as a third person, it is a sign of respect. However, today, ang pinopropose nila ay mas maganda yung first person. Kaya para, pag sinabing first person, more or less, yung pag narrate mo sa story, pag narrate mo doon sa investigation, ay more or less talagang, kumbaga, it is not coming from another person, but rather, it is really coming from your personal thoughts and from your personal words, yung idea nun, okay? So what else? when we report, normally it is a chronological order. So when you say chronological, no? The word chronological order is already redundant, class. Huh? You can just say chronological, that is already enough. So when you hear somebody say, just like what I'm saying today, that chronological order, that is already redundant. In writing, we avoid redundancy, yung repetition. Okay? Ang order is already a redundant or a redundance of logical. Because when you say logical, it is orderly. That's why when you say chronological, you do not need to say chronological order because it is already understood that chronological is already orderly. Now, what does it mean by chronological? When you say chronological, it is arranged by time. Okay? So logical, it is orderly. Now, chrono is pertains to time. Huh? So when you say chronicle, it is the story of time. Okay? So when you say chronograph, you are referring to a measurement of time. Okay? Kaya pag sinabing synchronize, it means to say that it should be at the same time. Kaya pag sinabing chronological, meaning when you report, it should be chronological, meaning magsimula ka doon sa pinagsimulan ng kwento. Okay? Hindi ka gumagawa ng kwento para sa libro or para sa television or para sa Facebook na mag-i-start ka doon sa dulo ng yung kwento. But in reporting, whether you are doing investigative reporting or you are doing incident report or you are doing a simple police report, normally you start from the very beginning. That's why in police report, you normally say that on or around or that on or about 0430 hours, okay, 3 March 2021, while I am patrolling, okay, at the vicinity of, okay, or if you are using the third person, while the undersigned patrol officer is conducting, okay, a patrol around the vicinity of, like that, okay? And normally, if that is a report, normally you are narrating or you are now trying to report things that are already, we call it things that are things that have already occurred. No, tapos na siya. Therefore, you need to use past tense. Huh? So, nag-report kayo tungkol sa mga past tense. I just hope na naintindihan nyo sa mga reporter. I just hope na nanood kayo yung mga iba dyan kasi wala kayong attendance. Tignan ko yung attendance nyo sa mga video, walang kukunti lang yung nagko-comment doon. Okay, na sila'y nanood doon. So, past tense ang gagamitin natin. Okay? So when you report, it should be past tense. Now, one of the common error ay yung word na happened. No? Normally, naririnig ko, the incident was happened. No? The incident was happened. No? Alam nyo, ang English grammar class, madaling maintindihan kung mali o tama yan. Kapag pangit pakinggan, wrong grammar yan. No? Was happened. The incident was happened. No? Okay? Hindi niya kailangan yon ng helping verb. Okay? So I will discuss that further later on. Now, we normally use active voice. Although, in the Philippine setting, passive voice is accepted. Ano yung active voice? When you say active voice, the subject is the doer of the action. On the active voice, okay, the subject is the receiver of the action. So ganito yon. Pag sinabing active voice, okay, I went to the police station. Okay? So that is an active voice. Ayan, okay? I gave the police officer 100 peso bill. Okay? So that is an active voice. So if that is a passive voice, ang sasabihin mo is the police officer was given a 100 peso bill by a man. Oh, that is a passive voice na tinatawag natin. So in the American setting, ang kanilang reporting ay active voice, okay? Kasi mas direct to the point yung tawag natin yung pag-narrate mo. So yun ang mas magandang gamitin, yung active voice, okay? The suspect stabbed the victim on his abdomen. Okay? So that is the active voice. The subject is the doer of the action. Okay? Kapag sinabi mong passive voice, no? The suspect stabbed the victim on his abdomen. That is the active. On the passive, the victim was stabbed Okay, the victim was stabbed by the suspect. Okay? The victim was stabbed on his abdomen by the suspect. So yun ang the subject now, yung pinag-uusapan natin, becomes now the receiver of the action. So that is the passive voice. Okay? So pwede rin yan sa Filipino English na tinatawag natin. Pwede rin yan. Pag sinabi kong Filipino English class, marami kasi tayong English terminologies na wala sa American English, na wala sa British English. Na kapag tinype mo yan sa computer, a-underline niya ng red. Ibig sabihin, wala doon sa standard English dictionary, pero nasa ating vocabulary. Marami tayong ganong klaseng English term class. Say for example, yung word na comfort room. Alam nyo ba class na wala sa English dictionary ang comfort room? Sa Pilipino, ang comfort room. No? Now, ngayon-ngayon lamang, dinadagdag yan sa English vocabulary, yung word na comfort room. Kasi sa mga English people, wala namang comfort room sa kanila. Ang meron sa kanila is toilet. Ganun yun ang ibig kong sabihin. May mga words na mga Filipino expressions or mga Filipino terminologies. Okay? So, ganun din yung ating pananalita sa Filipino, okay lamang yung passive voice. Kaya pag nagre-report tayo, ay passive voice pa rin. Pero mas maganda if the report is stated, okay, stated in active voice in which the subject is the doer of the action. Again, another thing is the correct spelling. Important yung correct spelling. Well, you are blessed, no? In your time class, you are very blessed because marami na ngayong mga dictionary. At the same time, kapag kayo nag-encode sa word document ngayon, ia-underline ni Word yung mga wrong spelling at merong suggestion. Minsan naman may mga auto spelling, no? Huwag kayong gumamit ng auto spelling kasi minsan yung auto spelling ni English vocabulary, ni American vocabulary ay base sa kanilang context, hindi base sa atin. Say for example, yung word na sinasabi natin, that the imposible penalty is life imprisonment. So, the word imposible is a Filipino English class. Huh? Imposible is a Filipino English. The penalty imposable to the suspect is a life sentence. Huh? Wala yon. Sa American English, walang impossible na word. Sa Pilipino, meron yon. Ha? So, tandaan nyo yung class, ha? May mga expression tayo na wala. Kaya kapag in auto correct spelling mo yung nagtatype ka, baka mamaya, iba yung sinadjust niyang word. Parang yung mga cellphone nyo, mga smartphone ninyo, naka-auto correct yung spelling nyo, minsan nakikita nyo, iba-iba yung mga naisesend nyo na message. Kaya, delikado yun kapag kayo gumagawa ng mga report ninyo, gumagawa kayo ng mga research ninyo, delikado yun. Okay? So, and the punctuation mark. Anong punctuation mark ang dapat gamitin? So, for example, sa question ko sa post-test ninyo, anong correct na punctuation mark after the salutation? Ano ba yung salutation? Dear sir, dear madam, di ba? That's the salutation. After that, what should be the punctuation mark? Is it a comma, semicolon, or colon? So, importante rin yung punctuation mark. Now, kapag kayo ay nag-text, ang ginamit yung punctuation mark ay exclamation mark. Alam yung dating kapag exclamation mark niyan, ang dating niyan nagagalit yung tao kasi yung mga punctuation mark na yan, hindi lamang siya nag-indicate ng possession, hindi lamang siya nag-indicate ng respect, minsan nag-indicate din yan yung emotion ng tao. Kaya pag galit yung tao, normally exclamation mark ang nilalagay niya. No? Kaya mag-ingat din doon. Kapag masaya yung tao, exclamation mark ang ilalagay mo, kaya nga exclaim, no? Isisigaw, no? Exclaim basically is masaya dapat, pero yung exclamation mark ginagamit din natin yon kapag galit tayo, no? Okay. So use the correct subject verb agreement. Now we are going to discuss that later on or na-discuss nyo na yan siguro. Ang pag sinabi nating subject verb agreement is that if the subject is singular, the verb form is plural. Ano yon? Okay, I sing. I is in plural term or we is in plural term. So we sing. So when you say, you do not say he sing, but rather you say he sings. Sings is the what you call the plural form of your verb. Okay, so importante yun na ang pinaka-basic natin sa subject-verb agreement or the SVA na tinatawag natin is if the subject is singular, the verb is in its plural form. Now, there are also exemptions to that. Kasi may mga plural na kailangan mo rin gamitan ng plural. Okay? Another thing is use correct pronoun. Ano yon? Yung paggamit natin ng I, we, okay, he, she, his or her. Okay? So yung mga demonstrative pronoun natin, yung mga possessive pronoun natin. Say for example, yung dear, no? Or there, no? Ano yon? There are, or anong spelling mo ng there are? T-H-E-I-R? Mali yun, no? So dapat correct pa rin yung spelling ng mga pronoun mo at yung mga pronoun na gagamitin. Now, avoid jargon and wordiness. Kapag sa report writing kasi, hindi ka gumagamit ng mga highfalutin words, okay? Hindi ka gumagamit na the snappy and handsome and skillful police officer. You do not say that. Okay? Just simply say the police officer like that, no? Okay? Avoid wordiness kasi pag masyadong wordy yung statement mo, ang tendency nun ay mas lalong malabo yung ibig sabihin nun. At the same time, marami kang dangling phrases. Pag marami kang dangling phrases and dangling clause, medyo mawawala yung idea ng statement. Ang idea niyang class is kailangan yung statement mo, hindi siya magbibigay ng double meaning dun sa receiver ng information or ng message. Now, in report, you write only the facts, not the opinions, unless you are asked to give your opinion. Otherwise, only the facts should be stated. When you say facts, these are the things that really happened in the past. Okay? Facts and reality are different. Okay? Truths and reality are different from one another. Even facts. When you say the truth, the reality, they could be the things of the past, or they could be the things of the future, or they could be the things of the present. Ano yon? When you say, the reality is, not all my students pass my subject. Oh, that is the reality. So pag sinabi ko naman na only 50% of my students last semester passed the subject, oh, that is now a fact. Okay? It's a fact because it is already a thing of the past. Then you choose the correct word to describe the incident. Kailangan correct yung word, no? So again, in your time, medyo kayo ay very fortunate kasi marami kayong mga technological aids na pwedeng gamitin ninyo sa inyong mga smartphone or sa inyong mga laptop. Then organize the report by using openings, okay? Always mayroong opening or may introduction na palagi. Now, say for example, kapag kayo ay pinagsulat ko ng essay, pag sa essay ninyo, dapat meron kayong palaging opening. Meron kayong introduction of the subject matter, tapos meron kayong body. Now, kapag sa report writing naman, always meron kayong mga openings. Okay? So, ano yung opening na tinatawag natin? Minsan tinatawag natin yan na authority line. Minsan tinatawag natin yan na reference. No? Say, for example, pinagawa ka ng report or binigyan ka ng activity ng iyong boss, inutusan kang gawin isang bagay. So pag ginawan mo na ng report 'yan, anong opening line mo? Sasabihin mo that in connection with, no? Or in connection with the verbal instruction of the chief of police, the undersigned police officer conducted ocular inspection on the site of the accident. So meron kang tinatawag nating authority line, no? Importante yung authority line mo or yung authority mo sa opening, importante 'yon kasi ganito 'yun class sa government or hindi lang sa government, sa mga official functions ng mga private and government entities, hindi ka allowed na magtrabaho na wala kang authority. Okay, importante 'yon. Say for example sa akin, okay? So what is my authority to teach you technical writing? Is it my skill in technical writing? Ito ba yung galing ko na sumulat? Of course, no. Okay? Ang aking authority ay nagmula yon sa aking appointment as your teacher. So, parang ganon. So, ganon din kapag police officer ka, meron kang authority. Bakit ikaw ang nagtrabaho doon? And normally, yung authority mo na yon yun ang nilalagay mo doon sa opening ng report mo. Saan manggagaling yung authority mo? It could be an inherent function of your office. Pag sinabing inherent function of your office, that is automatic function of every police officer who will be in that particular position. Kaya lalagay mo doon, inherent to the function of this office, the following officers conducted immediate responding to the crime scene or immediately responded to the crime scene. Okay? So, ano yung authority mo? That function is inherent, meaning likas na or talagang part na ng tinatawag natin ng trabaho nyo bilang police officer. Okay? So, and then in the paragraph, normally that is now the body of, we call it the narration. Nandyan na yung elaboration ng mga pangyayari or ng mga bagay-bagay na gusto mong inarrate. At the same time, it should be chronological. Okay, ang presentation mo yan. Of course, merong heading sa taas, no? Okay, so kapag... Na-